Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, depending where you are on this beautiful earth. We've had such a beautiful retreat in Santa Cruz, and I'm deeply grateful to our mystical hosts for investing so much of their love and activity into making it the truly wondrous experience it was and still is now. Thank you, thank you. And thank you to all of you who were there, and all of you who will be there as you now listen to the MP3s or CDs. Your consciousness and the experience itself is just as much yours as if your body were present those 3 days. The body presence doesn't matter, just consciousness is. Know that my and the group consciousness is just as much yours, whether you were physically at the retreat or you're listening to it now or in the future. The same love, the same peace, the same truth, and the same fulfillment of being is yours either way. Know that, bathe in it, and experience it as your truth now. We come today to a statement of truth that has been grossly misunderstood for the 20 centuries that have passed since the first telling of it. And because of this misunderstanding, the world, and perhaps you, have suffered and are suffering. You have continued struggling with the material life. You've battled with emotion, loneliness, separation from your every good, separation from your true love, which leads to a roller coaster of relationships that never completely and deeply satisfy, that eventually always let you down. You've experienced degrees of lack, restriction, limitation, insecurity, fear, unstable health, accident, struggle, or dissatisfaction with your work activity, or business success or career. By degree, you've struggled with home, money, commitments, demands. You haven't found your divine love and unconditional freedom of being. And it's all to do with the gross misunderstanding of this one truth revealed over 2,000 years ago in one statement that, ironically, is probably one of the most daily read or daily repeated statements for millions of people around the world. We'll get to that statement in a minute or two, but let's first set the scene. Imagine you are a character in a movie. You are the image character we will all see acting out its life on the screen when the film's released. The movie depicts the eternal existence through life phase after life phase of you, the divine being experiencing billions of individual aspects of itself, billions of divine beings, forms, conditions, each unique, each magical, each mystical, each a universe of love and fulfillment beyond measure. You're seen experiencing ever greater, more mystical, and more miraculous aspects of the boundless life of unfolding bliss that you are. Step after step, thought after thought, awareness after awareness, experience after experience is true adventure, exhilaration, beauty, bounty, laughter, life, fulfillment, activity, purpose, reason. There's no darkness of consciousness here, no sadness, no loneliness, no discord, no negative. Such conditions as unhappiness or loneliness or dissatisfaction or opinion, argument, war, poverty, insufficiency, greed, illness, disease, old age, decrepitude. These ideas simply have no place in the pure consciousness you are, and therefore are not in the slightest a part of your experience. They simply do not exist any more than dry water exists. Such an untruthful, unreal condition is an impossibility, a non-entity, therefore obviously isn't experienced. your life in this movie is that of the greatest miracle, adventure, enchantment, the deepest and most joyous and fulfilling purpose. It's the unconditional outpouring of the blissful and boundless self to and as your world, your kingdom. This is the pure truth of you, and it's the truth and actuality of you now. And therefore, this is what's depicted as the movie. Now imagine the movie is playing in cinemas around the world. And imagine that you're on that screen, your divine life unfolding into visibility as each scene, as each frame of film rolls by the light. And then, for a moment, your awareness up there on and as the screen activity becomes distracted. In a moment of lost true awareness, your attention is caught by a person or thing or activity happening on the screen. All of a sudden, instead of being the pure divine life, visibly evident as happening on the screen, you step away from it into and as the screen activity. You have thought, in this moment of confusion or distraction, that your image self on the screen is the true you, is your life and activity, your true life and activity. You've assumed separation from your true divine and infinite self and adopted a false identity of personality and finiteness. The very moment you've done that, your body and your word and your world and your mind and your activity are dead. It's just a matter of what the screen depicts as time before your body starts to deteriorate and your world and the beings of it, the things of it, the conditions of it also deteriorate and let you down. Your life is quickly now depleting because your substance is gone. You've stepped away from your one substance, your one life. Your resources are running dry and failing. You're becoming aged, dry, lethargic, feeble, incapable and incapacitated. All you have now is what you can muster from the contents of the screen, which of course is very little, always limited, always insufficient, always hard to gain. You've stepped from four-dimensional oneness, freedom, bliss, into two-dimensional separation, restriction and hardship. You've assumed a false personal identity when actually you are the one impersonal, infinite, divine, boundless, effortless being. How foolish and unnecessary that false identity is. Can you imagine if we were literally all sitting in the cinema watching a movie and the lead character, the image character up there on the screen, stepped away from his image to run his own movie up there on the screen? Can you imagine how bizarre and impossible that would be? The entire imagery of the character is, of course, nothing but light pouring forth from the projector through the reel of film to the screen. There's not an ounce of life possessed by the image of the character on screen. There is not an ounce of intelligence, resource, love, joy, adventure, activity, wealth, beauty, purpose. Every pixel, every cell, every breath, every thought, every activity, every condition, every awareness, every bounty, every beauty, every satisfaction witnessed as or as happening to the character we see on the screen is the light passing through each frame of film. There is nothing else evident at all not even one grain on the screen that isn't actually and only pure light passing through film imagery to produce screen imagery. If you witness a single smile on the face of even just one of the 6.8 billion beings visible on this earth today, it is the presence and activity of God, I, Spirit itself, passing through, in effect, the human sense of consciousness to be that visible smile. A person has not smiled any more than the movie character can separate himself from the light and smile. If you witness a single body form, it is the divine body of pure and perfect light passing through your human sense of consciousness, or mine, or collectively, to appear as a physical material body, whether that is one grain of sand or the body of one leaf or one flower. Nothing of the physical material body is independent or personal. Every atom of what appears as the physical is the divine, boundless, blissful, true body. The physical is just imagery. If you witness love, it never is love from a person. The person is nothing but imagery, and the love promised and expressed by that image is true love. That's why it lets you down if it seems to be coming and if it's accepted as love from a person. That's why 1 minute it is loving, the next minute it is judgmental or critical or argumentative or selfish or uncaring, or it changes its mind. 1 minute yes, next minute no. True love is never from one person to another, but is in truth the divine radiating pure affection, embracing you, relishing the deep things and activities of individual intimacy one with another, joyfully providing you with the utter freedom of unconditional love in every way. But it must be recognized as the one true love, even though it appears to be coming from and as what appears as a person. If you witness one activity, one gentle breeze on your cheek, one evocative bird song, one leaf dancing in the wind, one sparkle on the ocean's surface, one flower bursting forth, one heavenly aroma of lavender or jasmine or cherry blossom, one play of sunshine versus shadow in your garden, and the billions of other activities presented to awareness each day, it is not what seems to be, but what is. It is the divine, one, pure and perfect presence becoming visibly evident to you and me through the human sense of awareness. There is no life in the breeze, the bird and her song, the dancing of the leaf, the beauty of the flower, the evocative scent of lavender or jasmine or cherry blossom, the play of the light and shade. The only life is the one life, and this must be our continual awareness. The very moment life or any aspect of it, any voicing of it, any activity or expression of it, any form of it, is assumed as being that of a person or that of a personality called you or me, it's dead. It's a lie, a falsity, and it will let you down. You will experience degrees of hardship, unhappiness, frustration. You find yourself continually lacking in the very best things and experiences of life. You will find your mind, body, and resources depleting, drying out, having to be worked at or for, never with complete satisfaction or rest. Yet, at any moment, you can decide to return home. You can decide to step right back into the blissful freedom and completeness of the light you are. Right now, you can decide to stop being human, the false identity that's assumed a personal and separate life. Right now, you can decide to step into the one true and euphoric life you are and always have been in actuality, in truth. My friends, you can do it now. You can step home this minute. No matter about a single aspect of your so-called past, no matter how dire or urgent is your problem of health or wealth or love or happiness today, you can step back into your truth, your light, your all harmony this very minute to find your immediate and complete fulfillment in every way, and particularly the way most needed at this moment to the human sense or the human condition. The door is eternally open to your choice. And as you step through it, there you discover the miracle of your perfect life and the perfect life of your loved ones, your abundant wealth, your deep and true happiness, your true loving relationship of oneness, your utterly fulfilling home, your true purpose and activity. There is no process. There is no season you need to go through first. You can, and I invite you to, step here, home, now, and discover your bliss. The statement that's revealed the great secret of experiencing your divine perfection here on earth is found in what has been called the Lord's Prayer. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. That's the King James transcription. Lamb's description is, Thy will be done as in heaven, so on earth. This is more accurate and illustrative of the truth. As in heaven, so on earth, meaning heaven and earth are the one same place, presence, beingness, and activity. Other statements also provide the same truth. Thy will, not mine, be done. Relinquish yourself to God, or to I, to Spirit. Submit to God. Bow down to God. And so on. These statements are exactly the same as saying to the screen character, relinquish your personal, separate sense of life here on the screen to the light life you truly are. Submit to the light that's your true character here on the screen and all its thoughts, activities, and possessions. Let the light that is your only animation be your life. Your everything. Do not try to separate yourself from the 100% light you truly and only are. Otherwise, you're living apart from your source, your true substance, intelligence, activity, possession. You are not really apart from your true self and substance at any time. You can't be. It's impossibility because there is literally only oneness. You can't step out of oneness. There is literally only infinity. You are that infinity and you can't step out from it. But, and here's the whole secret, because all is consciousness. If you are consciously not at one with and as your true self, spirit, then it's as if you are separate from it. There's the whole secret. It's all about consciousness. And more than that, conscious consciousness or conscious awareness. You would be benefited greatly by listening to that last few lines again. That is the entire secret. And if you ponder that, if you take it with you at every step, you will realize the secret of revealing heaven here as earth. Our awareness cannot be passive. Can you imagine omniscience being passively omniscient? In other words, it's not in full awareness of its omniscience. That, of course, is nonsense and impossibility. And because there's just one being, one presence, one mind, we are that. You are that. I am that. Therefore, the that which we are has to be consciously conscious, consciously aware. Otherwise, it's as if we are not aware. And it is this non-conscious or non-active or non-live awareness that seems to be the raft of troubles we find ourselves experiencing and struggling with in or as this human sense. These struggles and hardships of human existence are nothing more than this. Every last element of your existence and mine is already flawlessly complete and euphoric. You are the finished kingdom existing here as you. For you or me to say, this has to happen before that can, or we can't do this yet, or I'm not free to express myself yet, my health, my abundance, my love, my activity, because this condition here has to change, then I am free to be this fulfillment or to experience or have this fulfillment. All of this is to completely miss the point. All is consciousness. You are consciousness, not physicality. Everything in your experience is consciousness, not physicality or materiality. The finished kingdom you are is consciousness, not materiality or physicality. So if you're waiting for something material or physical of this world to change or to become ready, you miss the whole point, and therefore you miss your bliss. You miss your life, you miss your love, you miss your perfect activity. You miss your perfect freedom and deepest fulfillment. You're being the prodigal, the screen character that's trying his or her own life instead of resting in and as the one true life that is the only animating form and activity called you and called me and called everything everywhere and everyone everywhere in and as your world. Now, listen carefully. It is when you finally realize and rest as the pure consciousness of the finished kingdom of spirit that your true life, your true love, your true wealth and true activity quickly and often miraculously takes shape, synchronizing beautifully and harmoniously in the seeming material world. But wait for it to take shape, wait for it to synchronize before being it, before stepping into and as it and you'll wait for eternity. You'll cloud your true good and deepest joy, truest love and fulfillment for eternity. You're making your own decisions rather than completely letting your good unfold in and all around your world, in your lap. Simply going with the flow of what's happening to you and for you without once stepping in and judging, telling your world what it is and why it should not be or should not be yet, or why you can't do something or be something or express something or have something freely now. If you know you are and everything everywhere is spirit, consciousness, love, peace, life, harmony, with capital first letters, and you then let the happenings that will always happen around you and to you and for you simply happen without judging or interfering, the only experience and the only outcome, without exception, is good to you and to all involved and as all involved. Please remember that. Please remember it well. And why is this true? Because you are and everything is the finished kingdom of perfect love and harmony, life and abundance, reason and activity, in every detail. If you would just relinquish the human sense of mind and its judging, its decision making, its thoughts of whether this is good or bad, or this is right or wrong, or this time is right, all this time is wrong, then your heavenly experience is quickly witnessed tangibly. The perfect life of your body and the bodies of those you love is quickly witnessed. The perfect love of your life is quickly witnessed as being there for you and with you, tangibly, as one true consciousness, two individuals being unconditional love together, as one. The perfect and deeply fulfilling activity is quickly witnessed in material, physical terms. But step in, make judgments, make decisions, stop the flow that's happening, and you cut yourself off from that perfection, that life, that love, your heaven here and now. Buddha describes the metaphor of the prodigal screen character we've described much more eloquently. He says, the external world is only a manifestation of the activities of the human mind. The mind grasps it as an external world simply because of its habit of discrimination and false reasoning. The disciple must get into the habit of looking at things truthfully. And with the relinquishing of all thought and egotism, the enlightened one is liberated through not clinging, meaning through not clinging to a false identity of personal self, with personal awareness, personal thoughts, personal decisions, personal judgment, personal activity, effort, acquisition. So the instruction was given, thy will be done, as in heaven, so on earth. And the reason this statement has been grossly misunderstood is threefold. First, thy will has been assumed as a will different from or excluding immediate and complete fulfillment of life, here and now. It's been assumed as some kind of ethereal, divine will which has little or no bearing on life as it's presented to us here today, and which we have to deal with in order to even survive or attain some measure of happiness and security and love and freedom. Secondly, it's been understood that thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven means that good materialistic earthly activity is the will of God. After all, it says, "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Millions of good, well-intentioned people, probably billions in total, have understood this as meaning to be humanly loving, kind, gracious, giving, charitable. That makes sense, right? Bring heavenly qualities to earth. And what are heavenly qualities? Well, we're told that God is love, God is charity, God is kindness, generosity, God is selflessness, God is good. Therefore, it makes sense that we are to be good, loving, charitable, kind, selfless, generous human beings. We read that we are to treat our neighbor as ourselves. Do unto your neighbor as you wish to have done to yourself. But thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven means nothing of the sort. And the good people who do earnestly and honestly try their best to be the embodiment of these good human qualities discover that they're just as prone to hardship, accident, illness, disease, heartbreak, loneliness and failure as everyone who is the walking embodiment of the worst human qualities. This is the age-old quandary. Why do the most beautiful and good people suffer the same tragic human conditions as the worst people? No answer is to be found until the moment we discover the truth of "Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven," or "Thy will be done as in heaven, so on earth." Third, heaven and earth have been assumed as separate places and different experiences. One now, one later. One in this life, one in another life. One practical and necessary during our experience here on earth. One impractical and not quite necessary yet until the earth experience is finished and the heavenly experience begun. Then we think we can catch up with being good and pure and heavenly. God will understand, after all, we've been busy here on earth trying to survive. Okay, let's discover the great mistake. And in so doing, open ourselves to the heavenly experience here and now, this very day, in every detail of the practical and tangible life, every hour, every day, every step, every thought, every moment, every activity. Thy will is spirit only. And if you are now relaxed and open, you will have felt, like I felt when that sentence came out, a great peace well up within you, wash over you, be this world. Thy will is spirit only. A great realization suddenly dawns. Oh my goodness, that has been misunderstood for all these centuries. There is only one allness. Therefore, only one will. There are not two wills, one God's, the other yours. There are not two different fulfillments, one God's, one yours. There are not two separate fulfillments, one now, one later, or one practical and required here as my earthly needed conditions, and another as my ideal heavenly fulfillment that can or needs to wait until after I've got my earthly conditions harmoniously sorted out. Spirit is the only being, the only presence, the only form, the only intelligence, the only mind, the only activity, the only condition, the only will. This is a spiritual universe, a spiritual world. You are, and I am, a spiritual being, the one spiritual being existing as blissful, individual, divine being here and now. And that being is you. And again, there is the deepest of deep peace and love here, as I know you as just the one divine being. There is only one existence, one universe, one world, one place, and it is heaven. The earthly sense of experience is simply the fractional or infant awareness of the infinite, boundless good of being that is heaven, that is you. That's all. Of its own, it is not real. That's the same as saying the way it appears is not real. It's illusion or mirage. You are spirit. Infinite spirit. The infinity of spirit. Existing right here as this very awareness you are being aware with. Your entire world is spirit. Being, the only being, the only presence, the only form, the only intelligence, the only mind, the only activity, the only decision, the only condition, the only relationship, the only activity, the only reason, the only purpose. And what is spirit? What is God? What is this presence, this consciousness that is spirit, God, you? What is its nature, its character, its life, its love, its condition? Spirit is, God is, I is, the deepest of deep love itself, eternal, pure, unconditional love itself, eternal, pure, unconditional life itself, unconditional, eternal, abundant wealth and utter freedom of self and expression and activity itself. Impeccably fulfilling home itself. Deeply loving companionship, friendship itself. Every moment, every step, every thought, every relationship, every grain of activity, every cell of body, every atom of form, colour, aroma, sound, is utter heavenly perfection and love itself, expressing through human consciousness as what we call visible or tangible moment, activity, thought, body, form, colour, aroma, sound, emotion. Yes, emotion too. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven, or thy will be done as in heaven, so on earth, means the one I be done here as earth awareness, your awareness. Spirit be done here as earth, as pure awareness, your and my pure awareness. The awareness you are aware with be done here as earth, not an awareness of things, people, conditions, earth. That is not as in heaven, so on earth. That is as in heaven, period. Heaven is 100% spirit. Heaven is incorporeal, infinite, and eternal life itself, love itself, activity itself, form itself. The instruction is to recognize that this earth is 100% spirit, to be 100% spirit as this earth, to recognize this earth as the heaven it truly is and nothing else. There is nothing but one place. As we've said before, a mistake was made an age ago, and that mistake is having two names for one place, heaven and earth. Let's delete earth and realize this is heaven. This is the very outpicturing of heaven. Yet, because it is flowing through this human sense or infant sense of awareness, it appears materialistic, it appears physical, it appears to contain both good and bad, both beauty and ugliness, both bounty and poverty, and so on. But strike out earth and realize that I am heaven itself appearing here, being this here-ness, here and now. And as I be faithful to thy will, the one heavenly awareness, the one heavenly recognition, presence, then heaven opens up in front of me as my world. In the Gospel of Thomas, Jesus says, "Know what is in your sight, and what is hidden from you will be revealed." Know that this is heaven, not a materialistic place called earth that's suffering so deeply and tragically. This is heaven, but thy will be done. As in heaven, so on or as earth. That is the great secret. We've been told, and we've discussed it earlier, God is spirit. Therefore, if you wish to worship God, you must worship him in spirit and in truth. This is God's earth. What else would it or could it be? Whose earth could it be if not God's? The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Yes, you are an element of that fullness, are you not? You are visible here on earth, therefore you are certainly an individual within the fullness that is spirit. So am I. So is your cat or dog. So is the supermarket, the park, the mountain, the ocean, the jasmine, the clump of mud. So is every fibre of wood and every atom of concrete or stone that is your home, your village, your town, your city. So is the tree, the lamppost, the paving stone. So is your favourite picnic spot, your favourite chair, your most sacred place, your most delicious food. And so is your least favourite place, your least favourite person, your least favourite building, town or city, your least favourite experience. All is, despite appearance, either good or bad, spirit. And the good or bad elements, the difficult or hard or lonely or untimely elements of this so-called human experience, are simply the foggy awareness. And that is what must be relinquished. Do you see that only the one will there is, the only will there can be, is spiritual will? There is no material will, human will, physical will. Thy will be done, as in heaven, so on earth. Means that we are to recognize the oneness of spirit being all. The oneness of spirit being this earth appearance. The oneness that heaven is actually the only place appearing as this material sense of heaven called earth. And do you see that because the only will is spiritual will, the only will is for and as your utter deepest good in every way? There's nothing of the whole infinite universe of good that isn't at your feet, isn't in your lap. Fully manifest and fully available for you this very minute to use tangibly, to experience tangibly, to have tangibly. It already is tangible because thy will is the only tangible. Funnily enough, the human sense calls tangible, such as body and all the organs and functions of the body, and love and money and home and business or job or charity or church activity. The human sense calls these tangibles tangible, but actually they are intangible. Do you see that? Certainly, if there's just one existence, spirit, which of course is the truth, then there can only be one tangible, and it's spirit. That's why when we seek what to human sense seems tangible health of the body, tangible love of a relationship, tangible success, tangible home, tangible personal and world peace, we fail because we're actually unwittingly seeking an intangible. How can an intangible be experienced tangibly? Of course it cannot, and that's why it isn't. That thy will be done means to recognize just the one I as everything everywhere, spirit to spirit, not spirit to material or physical or earthly. When thy will is done here as you, here is your very awareness, each minute, each hour, then the miracle of heaven is quickly and consistently witnessed. The one tangible is witnessed as in heaven, so on earth. We witness in what is called a material way, a physical way, an earthly way, but never are we again confused about what this seeming material or physical or earthly experience is. It is heaven only, even though, certainly, witnessed at the moment with or through an infant awareness, but nevertheless realized as heaven, because no other existence exists. This came out beautifully as the Santa Cruz retreat activity, and I know that some had and still do have difficulty realizing it, being it. Many got it and are now beginning to be it, and it's so very beautiful. But do you see that for as long as we have difficulty realizing and being the one will, the one presence, the one true and pure spiritual being, which is being the one true and pure spiritual awareness happening as us at every moment, we are being as ridiculous as the movie screen character trying to separate himself from the light that he actually is, to live an identity not powered by light, to live a separate life without the only substance he is and has, light. And in this separate way, we will continue to suffer all the various hardships of the human life, which is the separated false life. It seems as if we will be doing another retreat in California in January. And I realize that that retreat will be all about this very truth, the pure I truth, the pure thy will evidenced here on and as earth. The whole retreat has already taken form in my consciousness. Now we just have to wait for January 2011. I was deeply touched by the number of people at Santa Cruz who were either there as their whole reason to understand how to help this earth out of its current misery and injustice and poverty and cruelty, or whose true desire it is to lift themselves out of the seeming personal problems of ill health and lack and insecurity or lack of love, hardship, as quickly as possible, so that they can be free to be the saving consciousness, the healing presence for this earth and all its peoples, all its animals, all its forests and oceans, its valleys and lakes, its rivers and its fields, its towns and communities. It was very, very touching, and my best and purest work can only be to reveal to all who are ready, or to beat and whip if necessary, and with a good dose of love as aperitif and dessert, certainly, the only true truth that this mind you call yours, this body you call yours, this whole earth we call ours, is in fact spirit, heaven. And therefore no consciousness other than the heavenly consciousness, the pure spiritual consciousness, will evidence the harmony and love and life and beauty and bounty that is mind, body and earth and everything, everywhere, in it, of it, and happening as it. Only thy will be done, instead of your or my human will be done, will save the mind, the body and earth of the human experience. And thy will be done means the one I awareness be the only awareness happening as your and my individual awareness. The moment we step out of the pure I awareness, we're lost on prodigal thinking, or in prodigal thinking, activity, body, form and earth. And we will, unfortunately, and so sadly, continue to witness the decay and darkness of the mind, the decay and decrepitude of the body, and the decay and disaster of the earth. We'll never solve the suffering of the human condition, nor the suffering of the earth, until we lift above the material sense to the spiritual truth. I am devoting the rest of my experience in this lifetime to helping in every way I am aware of and become aware of the raising of human consciousness to spiritual consciousness. To me, there's no more important or valuable work. And in that way, the more of us who become able to relinquish the self-will, the human will, for the true spiritual will, which, remember, is always your utter and deepest individual fulfillment of this very moment, not a separate will that leaves you devoid of the practical fulfillment needed this moment and every moment, but also so much more than immediate individual fulfillment, so very much more. In this way, we will, as a growing group of true spiritual consciousness and presence, witness such heavenly events and circumstances, changing the lives of thousands and changing the appearing earth disasters and cruelty, that we truly are bringing thy will, as in heaven, here on earth, to the experience of all. Let's be silent together for some moments now. Let this be rooted deep in consciousness to push through and flower very soon and beautifully, tangibly. can as we end the call now. Sit in silence for at least a few more minutes, or perhaps a little longer, to let this take root. Don't think any more about it. Don't try and do anything about it at this moment. Just sit in silence, letting it be you. And then it will very soon blossom and become known to you and as you, with a capital K. It will become what your consciousness is. And more you'll be able to step into each moment, each day, each activity, each thought, as pure heavenly awareness, pure I awareness. And you will witness miracles opening out at your feet. Thank you so much. And I look forward to speaking with you next Friday. My love to you.
I hope you enjoy this spiritual audio. Like, share and subscribe for more.